won't.
I hate it won't. Puppies. Good podcast.
It's good to hear Ely's voice, right?
Dude's on another vacation.
I feel thrust.
Too light.
Yeah.
What's going on, everybody? Welcome to Inside the Pallet House, the only podcast dedicated to solving first world problems and hopefully helping you figure out what beer you should be drinking this week or this weekend or whenever. It's the biggest weekend in football, so I'm super excited. It's the official Super Bowl.
What?
Yeah, the Super Bowl weekend. Pretty excited.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
For
Bears fans.
Oh, does the last week of the year have implications for...
No.
Oh.
I get to play the Packers.
Oh, this is the only game you care about.
Literally, here we are.
Y'all have already played them though, right?
Yeah. Week one.
And?
Lost bad. Okay. Really bad. Really set the tone.
But if you end...
This is a
with
big
a win...
All right. You know I like to gamble.
Yes.
A little bit here and there.
Yeah.
And
you dabble.
I dabble. Well, earlier this year, the beginning of the season when optimism is high, as any Chicago sports fan, as a Cubs fan, as a Bulls fan,
yeah,
you know you're going to be the best. This is the year. This is the year.
Yeah. Actually, next year's your year. Like, if we're going to get drunk off that feeling, like, you got to feel good as a Bears fan, like, with your picks and stuff coming up. And, like,
yeah, and we're starting to look, yeah, we're starting to look good. Well, that comes. All right, so there we go, right? So I start the season 0-4, start the season losing to the Packers. Broke my heart. I was like, the Bears suck. Football sucks. Then all of a sudden.
But losing to the Packers is like an reoccurring
nightmare.
Theme. Yeah.
That's the word you're looking for. Nightmare. From Brett Favre,
yeah,
to Aaron Rodgers to now Jordan Love.
Yeah.
Oh, boy. Love seeing these guys have quarterbacks like this. It's great. Now, Jordan Love's suspect at best, but he beat the shit out of us week one.
Yeah.
Looked like a fucking conquering hero. Very frustrating. But we lost week one, and that hurt. But I thought, hey, no worries. The Bears will pick it up, right? We went 0-4 right out of the gate. Lost the first four games.
By design, right?
Now, for a man...
That's what y'all wanted?
Yeah. Now, for a man who had all the confidence going in, the single biggest bet of the last 365 days that I placed was clearly for the Bears to win more than 7.5 games.
Okay.
Yeah,
you do a lot of...
Of the futures.
Yeah, you do... what's it called? Not over-under. Like over-under for wins.
Yeah, for win totals.
Yeah.
I love that because every time I see a win total for any one of my teams before the season starts, I think that is disrespectful.
Yeah.
Just disrespectful. They don't know what I know.
How could they possibly know?
How could they know? Well, sure enough, the Bears have won 7 games this year.
Oh, snap.
And the final game of the season is in Lambeau Field, the frozen tundra, against the Green Bay Packers.
To get you over the 7.5.
To get me over the 7.5. And to keep the Packers from going to the playoffs. They win,
ooh,
and they're in.
Yeah.
I want to play spoiler so bad against those hateful, hateful Green Bay.
When I'm there with, whenever UVA's in that position, I know it's going to be a loss. Like, they always fall flat.
The Packers typically
don't. But that's exciting.
Don't.
Yeah.
But so for me... This
no, I'm saying when the UVA can be a spoiler, like they fucked that up.
Yeah, when
too.
when you're a bad team, this is what you have to look
for. Those
forward
are the
to.
W's you're looking for.
Yeah. So here we are to win.
Isn't it crazy? I know we've talked about this, but isn't it crazy how fucking good they are about picking those win totals?
Dude, they're at 7 I mean, right now.
And even scores, you know, over-unders, like, oh, like 43.5, where would you come up with that number? Yeah, like
43 or 44, yeah, is going to be the score,
yeah, exactly,
of that game.
Like, it's crazy.
Well, here we are. And when the Bears started 0-4, I basically wrote this off as a loss. I was, yeah, like, well, we're not coming back from that.
Yeah.
And then, you know, we'd win one, lose one. Well, sure enough, now we're on like a 4-game winning streak. So it just kind of evened out.
Yeah.
So now here we are. Game time.
Nice.
This is the Super Bowl. So I am treating this weekend like the Super Bowl. I'm going to eat. I'm going to drink too much.
Nice.
I'm going to have a blast. And
you won't do that on the Super Bowl because you will have already had your Super Bowl.
Well, to keep up appearances, I'll do it again.
Because you're a gamer.
But I won't enjoy it like
no,
this.
No.
This is all the money on the line. Like this fixes all the ills of my season if it hits.
Yeah.
Now if it doesn't hit, well then you can imagine it doesn't actually fix all the yeah. ills of the season. But I had already taken this one kind of into account as a loss. Like I had a bunch of money in my account at the beginning of the year. Threw it all out on futures. I've had to put money in my account twice this year. Has not been great. But now I've built up a pretty sizable nest yeah. egg. So I'm feeling pretty good. This is...
Well, I'm pulling for you.
Yeah, and we have the late game. Not the late, but it's a 4:30 game.
Yeah.
The sun will be going down. This is going to feel like the Super Bowl. I'm going to be up too late. I'm going to be cheering. I'm going to be cooking out.
I had my Super Bowl last week when I was in the toilet bowl for fantasy. And my team, the Bengals, were playing... the Chiefs, and the Bengals needed to win two games to get into the playoffs. And I, on my fantasy team, have Kelce and Mahomes. So I was like, all right, well, even if they
fantasy
lose,
blood.
I get the fantasy money. Lost in the worst way possible because Mahomes and Kelce shit the bed. Every point they scored was off the kicker.
Oh,
five fucking field goals.
Did the Bengals lose the game?
And the
too?
Bengals lost. So I
double
lost.
Loss.
Yes, I lost. Ooh. All the way across the board.
Well, I hope to not suffer a similar fate.
Yeah.
I stopped worrying about fantasy months ago, so that's not a problem for me. But this is my Super Bowl. Like I couldn't be more excited. So,
but
big Sunday.
Nobody will be here because.
Are
we still having people over?
Oh, yeah, we're open. Okay. We're open. Oh, yeah. This is the final
I'm still
game.
Confused as to when we're open here and when we're not.
Next week and then we're closed
yeah.
for a year. We burn this place to the ground.
Yeah.
Done with this place. Smells like pee in here or something. I figured out what that was, actually. I don't know if you smelled it.
Yeah, that was the...
the drip tray.
Yeah, the catch basin there under the keg was a science experiment.
That is, that's another thing you got to worry tap. About with kegerators. You know, there's little drips, one or two drips every time. It's like your dick in the winter.
That's right.
Or a syphilitic dick.
Yeah.
I don't know. Depends what you're into.
Depends on which model you got.
Yeah, they drip. But why? It's wintertime. I gotta like stall.
I feel like there's a direct correlation between like the lighter color pants I wear.
And
the more likely I am to get my own urine on me.
Yeah.
Like, it's like if I wear a white shirt, I know I'm going to get some food on it at some point. But, like, I wear a dark shirt, never drip anything on it.
Nah, not a drop.
Yeah.
And nothing.
Or a white shirt, I'll just rub up against the wall as I walk by something, you know, or, yeah. like, bump up against a filthy car. It's like, damn it.
Nothing reminds you of the ineffectiveness of a urinal, like khakis.
Yes.
You know what I mean? Like, jeans don't show it.
No, yeah. All the micro splashback.
Yeah. As soon as you roll up to a urinal with khakis on, you get to see exactly where the blowback occurs. You're like, ah. Cool.
Yeah, they didn't really. You see a lot of different makes and models out there, but they still haven't perfected it.
No, I finally learned that if you piss into the thing that like has all the little hairs sticking up, all the little cilia.
Yeah. The new mats that they had that had that look like a brush, basically.
Yeah, it's basically a brush. Like those old. I don't know if you ever had the brush when you were a kid. You would like.
Put your hand
thing over the finger.
Yep.
And you like comb your hair with your hand.
Yeah. You think that's what those are?
It's just the same company. It was like, no one's buying this shit. They were like, some guy was like,
yeah.
I've got it. I dropped mine in the toilet. I pissed on it because I was so mad. No splashback.
No splashback, yeah.
And they were like, change the machines, double that's the right. size. We're sticking them in there. But that's the only thing that seems to work. Because otherwise, every time I go in, I'm reminded. I'm like, oh, okay, it's a low one. Then I look down at my feet and right there at my khakis. Piss everywhere.
Yep.
It's a high one. Oh, there we go. Looks like I pissed all over myself. Which makes me think how much like piss is coming back on my own junk. Like other dudes.
Yeah, exactly. How much other person people's pee are coming back on you.
I got other dude juice.
I mean, it's a huge pain in the ass, but like sitting down is the way to do it.
Yeah, unless somebody sees you.
Yeah, well, I'm saying
never gonna hear the end of it.
Well, I mean, we never would as dudes, because like that's one of the great things is just the in and out of peeing in a urinal is way quicker.
Even the trough was more effective.
Yeah.
It doesn't blow back because you still got the high wall over here.
Yeah.
They removed the front wall. The urinals.
Yeah, you were like peeing down into a basin.
Yeah, it worked out great. Yeah, you had to see 50 other dongs, but you had to line up. But at least your khakis looked good. Yeah, you didn't get any man juice on your own junk.
Yeah.
It was a much better setup.
Yeah. I like those like 100-year-old urinals that were like to the floor.
Yeah.
Like you saw in like old buildings. Those things were awesome.
Made out of like ivory.
Yeah, and it was like a 5-foot tall urinal.
Those things, and they were like, you couldn't move them.
Yeah. Like yeah, they were setting the floor. It's like,
if there's a tornado, you just hug that urinal. That's right. Like, you will be fine.
And it's like, you got tall people, short people. It all works.
It works for everybody.
Yeah.
You don't need a special one for the kids.
You don't have the one little one at the end for the handicap or kids, you know?
Which always annoys me that there's the low one.
Yep.
Because now the pee is going to splash back all over my knees.
Yeah.
Just an awkward look.
Or you don't want to use it and have like a handicapped person roll up on you and you're like,
I never even thought about that they were for handicapped people. Never even occurred to me. I just thought it was for kids.
I think both. Aren't kids just handicapped people?
I mean, they're definitely not fully developed. I'll give you that.
Yeah.
But I never thought those were for handicapped people. So you think that's wheelchair height?
I think so.
It seems like an awfully long shot, though. You got to push out over your knees.
I mean, depending on how close you get, I guess.
Yeah, I hadn't thought about it. I'm sorry, I'm flabbergasted. You can probably just see my wheels turning over here.
Height challenge people, however you want to say that. Not just children.
Yeah, I'm not familiar. What's the term?
Me either.
why are you scared to say midget?
Have you heard the new, speaking of the new, I heard somebody talking on another podcast that the new Willy Wonka is actually really good. And Hugh Grant plays the Oompa Loompa.
What?
Yeah.
We can't give...
I know.
A short person, the actual...
Brad Williams, he's quite upset.
I mean, why would you not give this to a dwarf or a midget or somebody that could actually...
Little person, I think, is...
Okay. I think it's more offensive that Hugh Grant...
Oh, it is.
...is playing for sure. that I said the word midget.
Yes.
I just think that's more offensive.
Yes.
See me? Look, I'm woke as shit.
That's right.
I'm so woke. I'm mad at Hugh Grant. I'm boycotting Hugh Grant. No, I refuse to go see... Hold on, are they all Hugh Grant?
I think so. I think it's like CGI, like he's all of them, which is weird in and of itself.
Even worse.
Yeah.
Even worse. At least in the Barbie movie, they had the common courtesy to allow multiple people to be Ken.
Glad you brought that up.
No, you're not.
I watched it.
Oh.
I watched it.
What'd you finally think?
No one in my family enjoyed any of it.
Including you?
Including the wife, yeah.
You all hated it.
It didn't make sense.
No, it's Barbie movie.
I mean, it made like it. Like there were times where it was like, my boys were like, "This, I don't even really know what's going on."
No, like, it's very mental. It's very difficult to follow.
Well,
complicated.
I told my
wife,
I said, "Well, we know the history of Barbie, so we could kind of follow it. But like, how does any young person grasp what the concept of the movie is?"
I don't see how you're confused by this. It's very pacey. I mean, this is a throwaway movie. The fact that you guys were challenged, like mentally, like, whoa, can't follow.
What I did like, it was cool looking. It was beautifully shot.
Okay.
Like it was like, none of that shit was CGI. Like it was mostly like actual old school fucking effects.
Oh, I know what you're saying. So there's more like Star Wars 1.
Yeah,
they actually had to
like,
build some of this
stuff.
Yeah,
yeah,
yeah. I like when they actually build stuff.
And the colors were cool and everything. Like,
I wouldn't know.
Yeah.
I missed all that.
You couldn't even... Nothing pops on the screen?
Man, I don't see...
Even like hot pink, that like the Barbie pink doesn't pop?
I mean, I know it's pink, but it doesn't... I don't think it pops for me the way it pops for other people.
It is reddish, so that
this has been a difficult season for me in general with the whole colorblind thing. I've had a lot of people being like, oh my gosh, this is so beautiful and look at all this and that. Usually falls when I get pissed off
because all the leaves and everything.
Yeah, everyone just keeps talking about the leaves and I'm like, shut up.
Yeah,
I want them just to fall.
Yeah,
like, just fall off the trees, be done with this. So I never see it, but this holiday season
all I see now is a fucking mess. Like
when the leaves?
Yeah, I'm just like, this is going to suck.
Yes, well, that part does. but I just don't see the colors. Yeah. Like, I put up Christmas lights the other day, and, like, one of them was a different color. I didn't know.
Yeah.
So, like, I did three trees.
Yeah.
And my wife's like, that one is, like, lime green, and the others are white. Like, we look stupid.
No.
And I'm like, what's your point? I had to, like, change out the lights. It's frustrating. I don't see it.
In your front yard?
Yeah. Are they different?
I thought y'all always did wacky...
The one tree is the wacky tree. All that stuff now lives on the wacky tree, but I got them confused.
But I thought you just kind of changed it up every year. Just like, oh, we got this set of lights. I'll wrap it up this tree this year, and I'll do something different.
Apparently, we have now the full set.
Oh, okay.
And so it was like, you're not pulling that shit anymore. And I'm like, how am I supposed to know?
Yeah, we took all of our Christmas shit down officially last night and today. Yeah, it's over.
I did it last night, but I've left the front yard rolling.
I haven't gotten the yard up.
Yeah, yard is still...
You got a tree out on your porch, I can see.
Yeah, outside is up.
Inside's done.
Inside is now just the
doldrums. So now it's officially the worst time of year.
Yeah, it's just winter.
Just dark, cold, wet, miserable.
Yeah, we need another light-up holiday in like... February.
Into January.
That way everyone can just unplug their lights.
Yeah.
And plug them back in. Like, when's Diwali, the festival of lights?
That's a good question.
Because maybe I could just start celebrating
Diwali.
Probably
one of those that changes. But still, if it's in the same roundabout area.
I'd like to know now, because maybe that's going to be my whole argument. When is Diwali?
Google will tell me.
November 1st. Oh, that doesn't help at all. So I could put them up early.
That we don't need that.
I need them down late. All right. I need a made-up
President's Day or something. Valentine's Day.
I need to see something. I need a February light-up holiday so I can just unplug the lights for January, plug them back in for February, and then take them down. Then I feel like I get my money's worth.
Yeah, the Halloween and Thanksgiving and Christmas and New Year's really just get me through that first cold, shitty months. But come January and February, I'm just in a grumpy-ass mood.
Nah, this is the most miserable time of the year. And if the Bears don't pull off this W on Sunday, the spiral continues.
And I don't know what's going on with the weather, but I remember 20 years ago, like, St. Patrick's Day here in Richmond was usually nice. And I feel like the past 5 years, that's not been the case. It's been a lot of wet, a lot of still cold, a lot of dreary.
I'm finding that.
Because in my mind, and maybe I'm misremembering, but I remember like Richmond's known for throwing down on St. Patrick's Day. And I remember going out in the sun, in, you know, jeans and a t-shirt and like enjoying myself at these outdoor festivals.
That has changed though. You're right. Over the last 10 years,
yeah,
it's gotten progressively just a little colder. A little colder, and it's wet.
Yeah.
Which is appropriate, so I don't bother.
Yeah.
It should rain on St. Patrick's Day.
that's how you would like it.
I mean, that's what it's supposed to do. It should be a soft rain.
But I've...
Kind of like the blowback off a urinal. About that much rain.
So I've kind of trained my brain to think like... And it kind of is. It's a week before, but St. Patrick's Day is the start of spring. Here in Richmond, like, and so when it's not,
it's not anymore.
It's
just not. We get snow later now. All of our snow is like February.
February, yeah.
What the hell is that?
I heard we're going to get a lot this year.
Yeah, that's what they keep saying. The Farmer's Almanac that I saw in the outhouse.
That's going to suck.
You know, that's where the Farmer's Almanac was originally designed to be.
In the shitter?
In the outhouse.
Yeah.
That was just where you kept it, gave you something to read. That's why it was so fucking popular.
Well, we didn't have smartphones.
No, you need something to read. Read the Farmer's Almanac. Here's going to be a cold winter.
I used to always have stacks of magazines in the bathroom.
Yeah, if you didn't, you end up reading shampoo bottles. Yeah. And times were rough.
Yeah, you're reading like, what's in my toothpaste?
Yeah.
Like, I don't need to know this shit, but I got to have something to do.
I knew everything that was animal tested and not animal tested
exactly,
in my bathroom.
Yeah.
Now, I sit on the toilet till my legs fall asleep.
Yeah.
Just get into an article. It's like, it's me time. You never never read deodorant until your legs fell asleep.
No.
You're like, I guess I got to go.
Yeah.
That must have been the hardest thing as a man back in the day. You didn't really have that time in the bathroom. Now we just embrace it.
Yeah.
Like, as soon as that turd falls out, I set the timer for 20 minutes. I'm going to be here for a while. Like, it's on. Well,
wasn't that the old trope, though, that dads would escape to the bathroom for half an hour?
Yeah, but what the hell were they doing?
I guess being alone with their shit. Quiet time.
That's how bad it was.
I guess.
That's how bad it was. Didn't even courtesy flush.
Yeah.
Just living it. Oh. But you got to, because if someone comes in, you need them to get hit with that smell. You don't courtesy flush your own house.
Yeah, if you flush 5 minutes in, it's like, I know you're done in there.
Yeah, now you're being weird.
Yeah.
You know, don't be weird. They come in to smell it and go, my bad. And then they have to apologize to you.
I do remember once, and I don't remember if both my kids were born or just one, but I was at home all day with a sick kid, and he was wailing all day, and I was comforting him and doing, and it was just, there was no making him happy. And the wife finally got home, and I just gave the baby to her, and I just went into the bathroom and just turned the lights off and just laid on the floor in the silence of the bathroom.
What kind of horrible story is this?
Referencing needing alone time, like the bathroom is a good spot to go. Like, you can just get away.
But you didn't even sit everyone. On the toilet.
No, I needed dark, quiet, and I needed just to chill for a few minutes.
That's a low day. Next time that happens, you just call me, man. I can't know that you're dying on a floor.
It was, I just needed dark, quiet, alone time, and I don't have a walk-in closet, so the bathroom was where it was.
Yeah, even Elvis had the common sense to sit on the toilet.
They're not that comfortable.
They're not. Well, you need a bidet.
Yeah.
A little heated seat. Very comfortable.
Now I got the adjustable bed.
Very comfortable. You got the, you have elevated toilets in your house? Comfort?
Yeah, level. Like the 17-inch ones.
I've always understood the importance of the elongated bowl.
Yeah.
I like that. But, like, now they got comfort height.
Yeah.
And I thought we were trying to get our legs up. I thought the squatty potty was teaching us.
Well, now that's the thing. But at first it was like when the chair height ones came out, it was like, oh, this is your knees aren't up around your chest. So you bought the chair height. So your feet are flat on the floor. And then now it's like, oh, no, you need your knees up around your chest.
Well, so what's the truth? Like, what is the answer? Are we supposed to have our knees up to our chest? Or are we supposed to be comfortably, like, almost standing?
I mean, I'm not a doctor, but I would assume squatting would be better than almost standing.
we just upgraded everything to comfort height.
Yeah, I mean, we're built for comfort. This country is built for comfort. I mean,
so even though this is now somehow worse for squeezing a turd out,
yeah,
this is better.
Yes.
Okay.
Because we got to sit on the toilet for half an hour on our phones. Ah. That's more important than our gut health.
This is very true.
Yeah.
Get a Wi-Fi extender built in, put that bitch, so basically you're just standing.
It's like, it's like our cars. Like, I seriously think that a lot of our car accidents are because we have comforted out our cars to the point where the act of driving isn't asking much of a person anymore. Like, when we learned to drive on our 70s and 80s vehicles,
very true.
Like, you were fighting that wheel, you were fighting a shift. The windows definitely didn't shut out all the air. The doors didn't shut out all the air.
No, there's air leaking in everywhere.
There's noises are getting made.
Absolutely. You're
manually adjusting. I mean, just turning the heat on, you're twisting like actual manual knobs and like sliding shit over.
And it didn't just stay at a temp.
Yeah.
It was either scalding hot in there or it was cold. You were constantly fidgeting with it. I think you're right.
And now it's like,
it's a sanctuary in there.
You get in that thing, you can feel the pressure change when you shut the door in your car because it's so airtight. You got your Bose surround sound speaker. You got you're sitting in a recliner.
Your seats are heated.
You're steering with one finger because you got power steering and a lane assist and cruise control. You know, like, it's so comfortable. Like,
it's very easy to text.
Car, yeah. Oh, yeah. You're just like, why can't I text?
I'm on the couch.
Sitting on my couch.
Yeah.
Oh, another car's barreling down at me? I don't hear it. I got my fucking tunes blaring in my fucking airtight, you know, cocoon over here. Like,
it's very true.
Remember how loud tires just used to be riding down the road?
My two old cars.
Your old cars, you hear it.
I hear literally everything.
Yeah.
Everything going on around me. There's air leaking in all over the place. There's not a single comfort feature in either of them. You're constantly having to shift. I literally cannot text.
Yeah.
It's not that I don't want to. I want to be just as dumb as everyone else. Yeah. You know, I want to be just blissfully ignorant of all the danger around me.
Yeah.
But I don't have a choice.
No.
Because my car's drifting. It doesn't want to stay in a lane.
You put your left arm on the windowsill and put the one finger on the steering wheel in the little crevice. That car's taking off in one direction or the other. Like,
it'll kill you. Yeah. It'll kill you.
You better have a firm grasp on that sucker.
You hit the brakes, it's liable to lurch in any direction.
Yep.
On initial put down, because they're drum brakes, which work very differently.
It could be left sometimes, but it could be right.
Might. I don't know. I don't know where
this thing's going.
I'll figure it out when I hit the brakes.
That's right.
And then navigate all of the danger in front of me.
I will counteract whatever way it decides to go.
I am ready because I am fully engaged.
I'm driving. I'm operating a motor vehicle.
The car and I are one.
Yes.
Because I'm both going to die.
I'm taking input. I'm adjusting.
All the time.
Now it's like, fuck it. Put in the GPS. Let's see where this thing takes me. I don't even know.
Yeah. Turn right. Oh, hadn't even considered it.
I mean, just the GPS has made me stupid when it comes to operating vehicles. Like,
absolutely.
Almost like I use a GPS so much, even when I know where I'm going, I just blindly just start driving. I'm just like, oh, I could have gone a whole nother way, but I just follow that GPS.
I had to take my daughter to some like volleyball lessons on the other side of town.
Yeah.
And I was in an old car. I didn't have any of the official stuff. You know, I could put it on my phone, but then it's kind of a pain in the ass to use your phone if it's not going right into the machine. And like, I got over there the first time and it was like, it was eye opening. I was like, I've been here before and I shouldn't have been so excited, but I was like, I know where I am.
Yeah.
I was like, this road has always been here and it goes all the way there.
And I've been here.
And it was like, it was great. And I was so proud of myself because I left and I was driving along and I was like, I don't actually have to turn the way it brought me. Because if I go there, there's another street I know.
That's right.
It was like I was discovering all of this for the first time.
For the first time, yeah.
All over.
Yep.
It's crazy. And it's amazing how proud I actually felt of myself when like, I did get to the area that I was like, now I'm in the home
area.
It does.
It does impress you too when you stop and think about it. You're like, and those police, fire, and EMS people, they just would like get in those 70s engines and ambulances, and they didn't have a computer. One, it was like you had to know which street to go to, and you had to know which block the 1100 block
was. And if this one's jammed, how the hell do I get around it quickly?
Exactly. Yeah.
Like, yeah. It's amazing how far I have fallen that I was proud of myself from getting home. Like, I expect my dog to get home if it leaves and it doesn't know a single road in the neighborhood.
I mean, think of where you grew up when you first started driving, like, without GPS. Like, traffic everywhere. You knew how to get around everywhere.
Yeah, I could still go up to Northern Virginia in certain parts of it.
I bet my kids, get anywhere. Like, they're not even paying attention now when I'm driving. So they probably won't even know how to drive around the part of town they grew up in.
I quiz my kids all the time. We'll be driving, and I'll go, hey, let me know when I'm supposed to turn.
Yeah.
No, why? I was like, I just want to see if you know how to get home.
Yeah.
Like, we ride these streets.
Spoiler alert.
Every day.
They do not.
No. There's only one way they know how to get home.
Mm-hmm.
It's the way the bus goes.
Mm-hmm.
They know everywhere the bus goes. They can get you to any bus stop between here and their school, but that's it. So if they wanted to go to school, they'd have to stop by all these places. But that's how they can get to school, because they'll be like, you turn here. And I'm like,
they can make a right to go, or they'd have to make three lefts the way they know how to go.
Yeah, that's how they do it. They go, okay, you go out here, you turn around, you go up there, go down here, go down here, go down here. You're like, you know, we started at the intersection of our house. And you loop me around the neighborhood. But yes, we are here.
Yeah.
I was shocked, though, at how proud I was. I shouldn't be proud of shit like that.
Yeah.
But you're right. Input in cars now, it's way different. It's just so comfortable.
It's
shockingly quiet.
Quiet. So quiet.
It's unbelievable. People are like, oh, the road noise from my tires. I'm like, how do you know?
Yeah.
You have to have an older vehicle to even be aware of road noise.
Yeah.
That's just something I hear in my old car as you go by.
Yeah.
Oh, mud tires.
Yep. Yeah, especially if you have, you know, any aggressive tire at all.
Which is coming.
Any light truck tire in a new vehicle, you don't even, it's a whisper.
It is. It's sad. I miss the days of hearing just brrr the whole way down the road.
I mean, I miss the days of driving a stick and like fighting with the car and like feeling the power. Like, I mean, transmissions are smoother. Everything's smooth now. Everything's just.
I got 10 speeds.
Shocks are better. Everything's better.
Oh, dude, shocks. So I got that new to me
truck.
Still at 06. I'm just. And to me, I get in that thing and I'm like, oh Cush. My gosh, look how far these have come. And I'm like, I'm still almost 20-year-old car.
You know what people don't know that aren't car people? And it still gets me. If you just clean the shit out of a car, it fucking does so much for it. And I found a show called like Filthy Dirty Cars or something on Netflix. It's this 20-minute show, and they show, I don't know how much it's cooked, but they show these barn finds. And they show these detailers literally power wash it, you know, scrub it, do the interior, and like they make up these numbers. They're like, before it was worth $5,000, now it's worth $15,000. Like, you know, like they charge like $1,000 to $2,000 to detail a car for 2 days, but like it goes from looking like something that shouldn't be on the road to fucking a brand new vehicle.
Oh, I just took a car to get it cleaned. And when I pulled in, I was like, God, this thing's such a piece of shit. But I'd like thrown all the crap out.
Yeah.
Because I got to get this thing sold.
Is this the Infiniti?
Old Infiniti.
You have a detail guy?
I just took it up to the local like auto spa, but I was like, no. Give me the good one.
The good one, yeah.
They were like, well, that's $20 more, and all we do is the trim. I was like, do it.
Yeah.
Get in there. And this woman spent so much time cleaning this car that when it was all done, she was like, this is a really good looking car. And I was like, oh, thank you so much.
You want to buy it?
I was like, I'm actually selling it. That's why I wanted to get it cleaned up. She was like, how much? And I'm like pointing out, I was like, well, look, there's like a little rust spot here. Who knows what that's an indication of?
Yeah.
Just had the full exhaust redone, like this. She's like, it's beautiful. She's like, let me get this. Another guy comes out. He's like, how much are you asking for it? So like all of a sudden, little bidding war at the car detail place. I was like, if you guys had seen it 45 minutes ago before it went through there and before I threw out all the trash, there was like mold on the seat. Yeah. It was disgusting, but it looks great now. And I started looking at it thinking I should up my price.
Yeah.
It was like the first thing went through my head. The thing looks great. Black cars look better once they're
shiny. Do they want it?
The one guy says he does. He says he's going to call me. We'll see if it happens.
Nice.
It's been a whole 12 hours.
Yeah.
He hasn't called yet.
But still.
Slacker. Let's check my phone. See if I... Nope, nothing yet. I'm not holding my breath.
Yeah.
But it is amazing. Dude, I went and bought new shocks for that old... or new springs and new shocks.
Yeah.
I'm such a moron. I went and ordered the shocks. I knew, okay, 4 shocks.
Yeah.
That's easy. Front and rear. But then when I ordered the springs, it said front right shock, left front shock, and then it said left right rear shock.
Spring. Yeah.
Right. So I was like, okay, so I have to buy the front and the right, but then I guess they just, because it cost more for the rear shock. So I was like.
You thought they were like universal?
I just figured they were giving me both shocks because it said left front shock, right front shock, and then it said left
spring.
Right.
You keep saying.
Yeah, spring. I keep fucking that
up.
And then it said left right rear spring.
So you thought you were getting 2 springs.
Yeah, so I finally got my package.
But it was just
in.
One.
And it was 3 springs. And I was like, what am I going to do with 3? I have 2 springs for the front.
Uh-huh.
1 spring for the back. I was like, son of a bitch. I'd already set up a time to have it installed. Like, I was so excited. The package came. I was like, it's finally all here. I've slowly been stacking all
so
my
the
suspension.
Left, right means
it's universal on either side.
Yeah.
But don't forget to get 2 more on.
Yeah.
So then I called up the place.
I'm surprised they even sell them not in pairs. Like, even if you snapped one, I think you'd want to fix both.
One's sagging.
Ones.
Now it's going to be all off kilter.
Yeah.
But nope. Now I have to wait again. So my guy's going to be waiting. So I'm stuck.
So you're getting new shocks.
New springs.
New tires. New rubber.
Yeah.
Nice.
And that'll be it. She'll be ready to go. But You can't do it with four shocks, three springs. It just doesn't work.
Yeah.
It's just not how it works.
So
I know that
is
now.
It pushing you back a week or what?
However long it takes to get these things shipped from the West Coast to the Toyota dealership here and then to me. And I was like, well, can't I just come and get it from you?
Yeah.
They were like, oh, we still have to charge you shipping and handling.
Well,
like,
of course.
I was like, but you're getting them from the warehouse.
Yeah.
Shipped to you. I was like, I'll just come get it. You're 10 minutes from me.
Yeah.
They said, well, you can't do that. We still have to charge you shipping and handling. And if I place the order, it costs more than if you do it online.
So dumb.
I was like, are you serious? Is it going to save me any time if you just get it shipped there and call me? They're like, no. He's like, then you guys are assholes.
Yeah.
Like,
that's just an asshole move.
Yeah. And they literally said, if I placed the order on the phone, it would cost me more. I was like, don't you have any, like, anywhere in the area? They were like, nope, they're in the warehouse. It's like, so anyone who comes in, you have to order all the parts from.
So you got to go through Toyota to get an aftermarket piece?
I'm not doing aftermarket.
Oh, okay.
I'm getting the shocks from a different truck.
Oh, okay.
Because in order to save money, Toyota has the same mounts on either end. It's just some trucks have a higher spring rate and slightly taller spring.
Uh-huh.
So I'm just ordering those springs so I don't have to do any modification underneath. It's not a big lift. This is like literally the smallest possible lift.
Yeah.
But still will have like a factory ride.
Yeah.
Because it's designed for Toyota vehicles, just one that's slightly more off-roady.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's an FJ Cruiser. It's going to have an FJ Cruiser suspension on an older 4Runner.
Nice.
Super forums, dude. Internet.
Yeah.
It's ridiculous.
I know. I want to get that leveling kit put on my Jeep and get some new tires.
That's basically all they're doing.
Yeah.
It'll raise the ass end up half an inch to an inch, depending on how much. And then the front's going to get, I've got these, I've never heard of this, an adjustable shock. I thought the springs dictated height.
Uh-huh.
This shock will allow me to raise the front anywhere from 0 to 2.5 inches, depending on how much it takes to level
it out. Nice.
So I'm just going to level it out. So it should look cool.
Nice.
But not awesome.
Yeah.
There's a difference.
Yeah, but that's a stock truck that I don't know.
I'm not taking it overlanding.
I know, exactly. And I have a Jeep, so it's funny for me to have this take, but like, I like the cars I like the look of the car, so I don't like to do a lot of crazy shit to them.
But they never come from the factory.
Just right.
Just right.
Yeah.
They need an inch.
Yeah.
Somewhere. Just
a couple inches here and there.
Just to fix it.
More aggressive tires.
But don't screw up all the other stuff underneath it.
Dude, I'm on these Facebook pages for Jeeps, and they're just like, oh, I got a 6-inch lift and then put, 40-inch tires under it. Now this is all wrong and this is all out of whack. I'm like, because it's not made for that.
Yeah, you have to change everything. Yeah, the control arms, everything. All this stuff. Everything has to change.
Re-gear it. You got to get the speedometer done. Like, it's a whole thing, dude.
No, that's why I'm avoiding.
Steering gets out of line. Like, everything's out of whack.
Yeah, I'm avoiding all of that.
Yeah.
Because everything that's on that can handle a little bit and be adjusted and be fine. So I don't want to replace everything.
What size tires are on it?
I don't know. It's all metric.
Yeah.
Now. The hell is that?
Yeah, like,
I have to do calculations.
Minor metrics too, but like, I got 31s and I'm going to go to the equivalent of 33s because I can, which they say I can get 35s under, but there's some rubbing. So I'm like, I'm just going to get 33s.
I'm basically not doing any rubbing, but I want to get the suspension put on before I put the tires on.
Yeah.
Because God forbid. But then now that I've had this setback, I've changed my whole tune and I'm thinking about going up, getting the tires put on that basically the internet says is the best size for me.
Yeah.
And then I'll put the lift on in a week and be like, all right, now it works. But then it's like a whole week of like, don't turn too much.
Yeah.
And screw up your brand new tires.
Well, is something wrong with your shocks?
The one shock has a leak. That's enough to send me off a cliff. Like, I'm like, that's it.
Yeah.
All the shocks are coming out. All the spring. No, at that point, it's all happening. It doesn't take but a slight nudge.
Yeah.
Because when I bought it, I go, you know what? I think I'm going to keep it just as is. I think it actually looks great.
And that was never going to happen.
Yeah. They said, your tires are old. I was like, oh, old. And they said, you have a leak in your shock. I said, burn it.
Yeah.
Whole thing's changing.
Take everything off underneath and we'll just start from scratch.
If you can fix it for $200, I say fix it for $2,000.
Yeah.
But make it look cool.
Yeah.
It's going to look Real nice. Real nice.
Well, I'm excited for you to move that Infinity.
Yeah, we'll see if it happens. If any buyer, any listeners out there want an old 2007 Infinity FX35 that it's got gremlins.
Yeah.
If you like gremlins, just don't feed it after midnight and don't get it wet.
That's right.
I think you'll love it.
It's the perfect car for you.
It actually has a brand new exhaust.
So it sounds great.
That's kind of all that matters. You don't buy those Infinities for anything outside of the fact they're quick. They sound fucking mean.
Yep.
Outside of that, who needs it?
There you go.
I do have a deli for us.
Oh, yeah. Is it deli time? Close enough?
On the nose. Dude, I'm playing this one by the books.
Dude, how was your New Year's, man? This is our first show after New Year's.
It wasn't good because, you know, the holiday drinks were bad. No one was happy. I didn't like losing the holiday drink challenge.
You're upset?
I stayed upset through the entire thing. I saw some comments on Facebook and different places, people saying, oh, I know how this goes. I guess I should accept that it's
a tradition.
You
didn't come in last.
I didn't.
That was for me.
But now I want to win.
Well, that loss is on you.
No.
Yeah.
No, I...
You called in two ringers.
I know.
And being a gracious host, you were never going to vote yourself over those two guys.
I literally voted myself first. I gave myself the highest score possible.
Yeah, you did.
And I still came
in. But that's what most people that make their own drinks do. Most people are kind of funny about that. We got the Maui Brewing Company Sunshine Girl Golden Ale. Light and refreshing golden ale with tropical and citrus hop aromas. 4.6 ABV.
It's a perfect beer. By the numbers.
Maui?
Yes, it is.
That's wild. How did he get that here?
Yes.
Yeah, shout out to your neighbor.
Yeah, so Mike, thank you so much for helping us out with this deli. I'm super excited about this. Now, Mike apparently came over... And he dropped it off on the front porch.
Brewed and canned by Maui Brewing Company, Denver, Colorado, on behalf of Maui Brewing Company, Kihei, Maui, Hawaii.
There you go. It's official.
Crafted with passion, inspired by paradise. We are an innovative and independent brewery. Welcome to the Ohana.
Aloha, Ohana.
Ohana.
Okay. So he brought it over here. And I guess like he knocked on the door and no one answered the door, per tradition at this house. And he left it. Then he came back a little bit later with like the whole neighborhood exchanges like little gifts.
Yeah.
And so
we kind of do that like treats and whatnot.
Yeah, things people make. You know, everyone's got their specialty.
Not the whole neighborhood.
Immediate neighbors, you know. And then he came by and he dropped it off and... He was like, yeah, you know, I left some beer here earlier. And I was like, oh, I don't know anything about that.
Yeah.
And he was like, oh, well, I hope no one took it. And I'm like, no, I mean, sure, it's here.
Yeah. You know?
My wife had just never bothered to mention.
To tell you.
Yeah, she was like, yeah, I found a six-pack of beer outside. She thought it was a whole nother Boo Boo Mysterio type situation where someone was just... bringing by random beers, which does happen from time to time with this podcast. It is interesting how people will just bring beer by the house. It's also freaky that people find my house.
Yes.
So it's like I'm always torn when that happens. I'm like, oh, that's really cool. And then I'm like, what the fuck, man?
Yeah.
How do they know?
Well, it's pretty easy to find out.
Yeah, but I don't like that veil being lifted often. You know what I mean? I'm like, oh,
yeah.
Okay, people know. But then he was like, oh, well, I'm sure it's there. And then he texted me a little bit. He's like, hey, for real, like, did you get it? Like, because if your wife doesn't know about it, like, and I was like, no, I got it. I went and talked to her. So, but yeah, we wouldn't have known who it was had it not been for the Christmas gift coming from them.
Nice. Did I tell you about the story? Did I tell you guys about, I got my wife got the rings working, the ring doorbells. They'd like malfunctioned, like disconnected from my Wi-Fi when we got new Wi-Fi. And then I lost the tool. And anyway, my wife got them back up and running. She ordered stuff online to fix it. So now I'm getting all these ring notifications again. And she had noticed Did I tell you this story? Stop me if I've told you this story.
I don't know this.
Okay. So she noticed she puts the little tree baskets out. And she was like, man, the Amazon people are actually enjoying the sodas. And
we do the same snacks. Thing. And my wife likes it so much that every time I see one take it, I actually show her the footage.
Yeah.
So she can see someone grab some Doritos and a Gatorade. And it makes her happy.
So and then literally later that night, I get the notification. So I jump on the phone to look at it. It's this little ass kid that lives two doors down from me. Fucking coming up and grabbing the shit and running off. So I immediately get on the ring. I'm like, hey, I'm like, put that back. That's not yours. That little shit has done that two or three times. I've busted his ass. I need to go down there and talk to his guardians. I don't think they're his parents. I think they're his grandparents.
That's probably why his parents got rid of him.
Yeah. But I'm like, you little shit. Because who knows how long he's been doing that.
It's the holidays.
He's always riding his bike up and down the street. And his little grubby hand.
What a shit. Riding his bike in the streets.
No, just.
I see that you're looking at me like, you're not daring me.
No.
He's stealing my food.
He's stealing my shit. Which just isn't. And he knows he's wrong. Because you could see him like sneaking. And the ring had been working for a while. So who knows how long he'd been.
He's been getting away with it for years. Yeah. He's like, what the hell?
You don't want to instill that in a kid. When I say little, this kid's 8, 9, 7. Like,
living off the land, man.
I mean, he is. And I don't know how bad he's got it at home. Obviously, something's fucked up.
Yeah, like, what if he's the only time he's ever seen Gatorade is in that little bin outside of your house?
That's his problem, though. I'm sorry. Like, I can't instill stealing, like, just because you don't have it. I'm sorry, there's a lot of things my kids
don't
have.
What does it say?
Have.
What does the sign say?
It's like, thank you for all your hard work, you know, help yourself to a treat, blah, blah. You know, it's obviously.
Okay, no, and that's what I was wondering, because my wife just says, like, Merry Christmas. And so it's like, I'm always like, do they know that's for them? But then the amount of them that take it, I'm
they
like,
gotta
they
know.
Yeah, they do.
I mean, who else would it be for?
Yeah, I should probably keep one out year fucking round.
Yeah, I mean, honestly.
The amount of crap these people.
I mean, not a week goes by, we don't get something.
That's what I'm saying. Just a little something.
We got something today. Ordered a bat for my son.
Was it a spring for an FJ Cruiser?
It was not. It was not.
That's unfortunate.
You're looking for one. I'll keep my eyes peeled.
I just need one. A rear one. Apparently, either side.
If one showed up on my fucking doorstep, wouldn't surprise me.
That'd be great. I'm looking for something from 06 to an 09 FJ Cruiser. That would be perfect. Yeah, but so Mike brought this by and he said that he tried it out there and he really liked it. And they were out there in Hawaii and he was like, I need to bring this back for the guys.
This is an interesting beer.
It's a very interesting beer. You know what I like about
this
beer?
There's a lot going on in this beer for being a golden ale.
But it's also a basic bitch beer.
Yes.
Which I can appreciate. Like, as an American, this is what beer's supposed to do. But it is different than your basic bitch beer. It's softer.
First pull came across very hoppy to me. Like, it tasted very hoppy, but it's mellowing now.
It's super mellow.
But it's definitely got way more than your average domestic beer.
Oh, absolutely. But you know what it strangely tastes like? It also has a hint of like that, put it in the Heineken, St. Pauli.
Little hint of skunk in there.
Amstel. You know what I'm saying? And it's just a hint.
Good amount.
Of that.
Where like the Heineken's a little too much.
Yeah, as I'm saying, just enough of that so you know that it's more quality.
Yeah.
And then it has like that little bit of hop kind of comes at it. It's a very interesting beer. But I think if you were at a party and your buddy's like, no, I only drink Bud Light, Miller Light, like, you know, like a lot of places they go, you go to a brewery, people are like, I don't drink this stuff.
Yeah.
I just like my American beers. I think this would be a perfect thing. You could go try this. This is a very good gateway drug to other beer.
Yeah.
Like better beer.
It's a stepping stone beer.
Yeah.
But it's also one you could drink a lot of and drink them all day.
I intend to. Yeah, I'm really starting to come around on this beer more and more.
Is it a deli winner? Is it a 3.5+?
For what it is, a golden ale, like a basic bitch beer, to have all the complexity of like a European beer without any of the pretentious over-the-top flavors and nonsense. But then to still have that like really mild hop.
Yeah. And it's not lean. It's not cheating and leaning on a.
It's not leaning on anything.
Like it's got, it says Citra hop or whatever, but it's not a lot of that. Like it's not. No. It's not cheating by just going strong on a flavor that you're going to like. Like it tastes like a beer. It tastes like a beer.
This reminds me of the Gold Leaf Lager coming out of Devil's Backbone.
Yes.
Which I'm actually also a huge fan of.
Yeah.
Because
I think everybody liked that one.
It won a deli.
Yeah.
Because this takes on that perfect, refreshing, kind of just American beer, which is funny for a bunch of Polynesians. But no, I think this beer is about perfect when it comes to American style beer.
I agree. I like it. I just don't know what I want to score it.
I don't want to take it over the top, but I 100% how refreshing it is, how light it is, how good it tastes. That's a 4 for me. I really like that beer. I will drink this again. This is a lot better than that Salt Life. And that Salt Life, I thought, had a similar concept.
Yeah.
But this is actually a superior beer.
Yeah.
So if you put the Salt Life next to it and this, I would choose this. This is like, if I'm going tubing, I'd love to have a bunch of these. I'm a big fan of that. Now, so, I'd hate
again,
to find...
Again, this is the Maui Brewing Company Sunshine Girl Golden Ale.
Yeah. That's good beer. I'm giving it a 4, and I literally could debate on if it would go higher. This is one of those situations where if we could do quarter points,
yeah,
I'd go 4.25.
Yeah, I like this beer. I'm going to score it.
Oh, burying the lead. I like it.
I'll just give it a deli. I don't know what I want to score it. But I don't even know what we have to score to make it a deli, but it's a delicious beer, and I like it. So if it's got to be a 4, then that's what I give it.
Wow.
I'm not going to overthink it.
No, but it is a 4, right?
Yeah, it's a great beer.
Like, that's a great beer. If someone ordered a pitcher of those, you'd be like, great call. If you could get a bucket,
yeah,
6-pack of these, that's a good time. So it's a 4. You gave it a 4 also.
Yeah.
That's a strong score.
Now I want to, I've never been to Hawaii. Now I want to fucking go sit on a beach somewhere.
That's why you want to go to Hawaii?
No, I'm just saying, like, this fucking cold and this bullshit rain and weather, like, I'm already tired of it. And we still got
it's just starting, dude.
Yeah.
It's just starting. Get used to it.
It's going to be brutal.
Dude, Mike.
Way to go, Mike.
Fucking psyched about that.
You're a hero.
He did it. And in my mind, now I don't know if he actually brought it all the way from Hawaii or if he just said, I really need to get that for the guys and then went and picked it up. But in my mind, he brought that all the way from Hawaii.
I like it.
That's strong.
Yeah, boo-boo, tighten up.
Yeah, boo-boo.
California.
Boo-boo's been sucking. It's ridiculous.
We haven't heard. Ever since we figured him out.
Ever since we figured him out, he clammed up.
Took the fun out of it, which I get.
Which, though, also made me feel a little better. Because there wasn't some weird person.
Wasn't so creepy.
Yeah, it was a little less creepy. So I'll give it that.
It was kind of creepy.
Dude, when was the last time you had a physical?
You know what's funny? Now that you say that, I go to the doctor regularly and get blood work done because I hadn't had a physical in 5 or 6 years. And about 5 years ago, I went to get a physical and got the worst physical ever. We talked about this because you and I had the same doctor.
Yeah. 5 years ago.
And that guy retired.
Yeah, and I've got his counterpart.
Me too.
Mr. Happy.
The little guy, right?
Oh no, I got Mr. Happy. He's also old. He'll be retiring.
I must have someone else.
No, my guy just giggles. all the time. He's like, oh, that could be cancer.
Oh, Lord.
I'm like, oh, your bedside manner is actually fantastic. Yeah. But wait, what?
Yeah. What'd you say? Yeah. I mean, and you know, so I started going, I went and got a physical, and then I've been going every 6 months for quite a while, years now, and I haven't had another physical. Now that you mention it, isn't that supposed to be an annual thing?
I do mine annually, and I do mine right in holiday season, like around like December 20th.
But I heard now they just do blood work. That's how they do it.
That's precisely what they do. Like you could go to LabCorp and get a physical.
Every time I go to the doctor, they take blood and test it.
Yes.
And if I don't come in there with, oh, this is this, and I'm having trouble with this, I don't think they worry about it.
Do they do blood work when you just go in for normal shit?
Pretty much, yeah.
So then you're kind of getting a physical. Because my dude doesn't even, like, one day he just stopped grabbing my nuts. You know,
my guy,
like,
never grabbed my nuts.
Like, back in the day, they'd be like, cough.
Yeah.
You know?
You'd turn, like, your head and cough.
Yeah, that was pretty standard procedure. Now I keep going in there. I'm doing it every month, just waiting for him to grab my junk.
Our old doctor. Yeah. Our old doctor, he didn't do any of that. He chit-chatted with me more than and when I say chit-chatted, I'm talking about not my health. We were just bullshitting.
Yeah, well, he was from Barbados. Yeah. He would talk to you about Barbados.
Oh, my God,
dude.
Tell me about his kids and going here and doing this. And I'm like, I mean, he made me, like, he listened to me breathe.
They listen to you breathe.
And he, like, checked my reflexes. I didn't take a shirt off, didn't have to drop the pants, didn't do anything.
So when I first started getting physicals, turn your head, cough, pretty standard procedure, you know. Check your reflexes.
He made me squat, like getting a deep squat.
Yeah, they would make you do all these like physical, or they would do these manual manipulations.
And I think he made me like push on his hands.
Yeah, now we've gotten to the point where I go in there and he's like, "How you doing?" I still get he puts this stethoscope up and like ask me a bunch of questions.
Listen to your heart, listen to your breathe. Look in your throat, look in your ears, look in your eyes.
Yeah, real like a school nurse.
Yeah.
And then they do an EKG, which they send someone else in to do.
Yeah.
So I'm doing that. I feel good about that.
They've never done that for me.
They're checking my heart. So I'm like, all right, that's cool. But then it's all blood work. But then...
Well, I think they can tell a lot from that.
They can.
Yeah.
But then I was like, I'm getting old. And, like, you never stuck anything in my ass.
Yeah.
Like, I've always been told that a finger goes in the ass at some point.
Yep.
Check my colon.
Yeah, they've never checked me either.
So.
That's prostate exam.
That's prostate?
And when they do the finger. Colonoscopy is where they scope you.
Well, so I was like, I was in there and I was like.
Which you should have had both by now.
Yeah, I got nothing.
Yeah.
So I finally said to him, I was like, hey, man. Like, I feel like I should, like, get my colon checked. He was like, nah, you're good. And I'm like,
wow.
Kind of old.
Did he ask about family history?
Yeah, he's like, no one's had it. He's like, you know? Like, he just giggles at me.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And I was like, well, then could I, like, get, like, I see these ads for, like, Cologuard. It's like, can I do one of those? He's like.
Oh, or like, were you pooping a box?
And he was like, yeah, I'll order one of those up for you. I was like. All right, let's do that then.
Yeah.
Like, that sounds better than like shitting for 2 days and going under.
Well,
I think
honestly, in the defense of the shitty doctors that are out there now, from what I'm gathering, just coming up with my own
the blood work
here,
shows it.
Well, the blood work shows it, but every fucking ad on our TVs now is fucking for medicine. So I think most people go into the doctor saying, I have this, I need this, check me for that. So when guys like you and I come in that are like, I think I'm supposed to be here because of my age.
Yeah.
And we don't have any major ailments. They're looking at us like, why the fuck are you here?
Yeah, like, you're healthy.
Yeah. But I'm like, I'm trying to be preventative. I don't want you to find out colon cancer when it's too late, or prostate cancer when it's too late, or whatever cancer.
Well, that's what I keep hearing, right? Like, I get this. So I was like, yo, can I get like a Cologuard or something? And he was like, sure.
Yeah.
Glad to order you one.
Glad you brought that up.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Guy your age should probably be worried about that kind of shit. So he's like, yeah, I'll order you this thing. So like, it's on its way here. Well, my wife just did one, so I just got familiar with the process.
Did you help her?
Well, always. Well, I don't let her shit by herself. She's from Jersey. And I feel like if you can't pump your own gas, you probably shit by yourself either. So I always go in there. We do full service.
Yeah.
You know, so I stand there. I let her shit.
And then you operate the bidet for her?
But I watch.
Yeah.
And then, yeah, I just
hold her hand.
Operate the bidet.
Yeah.
Go through all that. I don't wipe anymore.
No.
Because she's a grown up.
That's right.
Just bidet her ass for her. Hold the remote. Tick, 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 tick.
Is that a 2 or 3 today?
Yeah.
How warm do you want the water today, madam?
I don't think you have enough fiber.
That's gonna be a deep clean.
Yeah, you're gonna have to be here for a few minutes. You may as well start looking at your phone. You get no private time in the bathroom. This is only men get private time on the toilet. Women, I will be here. I will hold your hand. You poop.
Oh.
Full service. Full service. Want me to check your oil? So I was like, let me get this
cold. You're court low.
Fortunately, I could fill it up. Top that off for you. That one was so funny. The turtle jumped down into the water. Yeah. That shit was hilarious. But yeah, I was like, let me get the cola garden. I was like, how's this work? You know, like I'm talking to him. And he's like, oh yeah. You know,
I don't know. The guy's like, I don't know.
Basically, I'm going to, you take something, you put it over the toilet.
Yeah.
So they were like, don't pee when you poo.
Yeah.
I'm like,
is that possible?
I don't know if you understand how this works, yeah. But like I contract these muscles.
Yeah. It all comes out.
Yeah. I've been known when I really have to poo to be peeing. And all of a sudden a little something comes out and I just have to sit down real quick.
Yeah.
Because like same muscle group.
Yeah.
Like I haven't actually dialed that in.
Yeah.
And I'm an old man. You think I'd have this figured
out
by now.
You're going to need to take a Gatorade bottle in there with you.
Yeah. Shove my dong in it just to make sure I don't get it.
Yeah. Because
apparently pee will throw it all
out. Oh, yeah.
So,
oh my God, there's so much urine in your poo.
I think you got some tubes twisted up.
Something's intersecting with something.
Yeah, your urethra's running right to Uranus, yeah. Man. This is bad. So they're like they put like a cellophane dam on your toilet.
Nice.
You stick it on there, and then they say don't pee, and then you shit into the dam. And then you collect your shit, you put it in a box, and you send that shit off.
In the mail.
But you go to a UPS store.
That is wild.
To drop it off. So those people.
Isn't that against the law?
Not anymore. It's actually healthy.
Somebody approved that.
This is why UPS people have pink eye all the time. All the time. I mean, I gotta believe this is not. Like, when you signed up, like. You thought maybe the worst that would happen is someone might try to send some drugs or something through the mail. But you're literally handling dookie.
You're like, this might be a brick of heroin. This might be a brick of pot. This is probably somebody's photos. This is probably a gift card. This is a box of shit.
It's a box of shit. And they've got to know when it shows up
in
that box.
Oh, yeah. That shape with like that address. They're like,
I'm handing you my shit.
I have handled 47 different boxes of shit today.
This is, it's got to be coming that the suicide numbers, UPS store workers, got to be going.
You got to think, like, there should be some hazard pay in that.
You would think.
Like, I didn't sign up for that.
No, but I was laughing with my wife about this. I was like, hold on, you took it to the UPS store? She's like, literally, and it's in the box they give you. So, like, every time they get that box, they're looking you in the eyes going, you've dropped off some shit.
That's right. Yeah, it's not some like bland cardboard box, I'm assuming.
It says fecal matter.
Oh.
No, I don't know what it says.
It's got the big shit emoji on all six sides.
But it's got the Cola Guard logo, sure. Like,
yeah.
And like when you walk in, like my wife's a good looking woman. Like she had to walk in and like just hand that to someone. Be like, here you go.
And then there's creeps fucking working in some of those places too.
And how do I know when they're not fingering the shit?
Yeah.
And then they might infect it. And now they're going to be like, you have colon cancer.
Yeah.
Freaking me out.
Wild times.
But mine's coming any day now.
You think you should do that in a healthcare facility, right? Like, you why can't I do that at the doctor's office and let them handle it and get it to the powers that be?
They signed up for it.
Yeah.
They took a Hippocratic oath.
Yeah.
They're going to help me.
Yeah, you're down with being around people's junk and privates and feet and fucking armpits and...
I stick my pee in a cup and I stick it in the little door and I shut it. That's they right. open it on the other side and they take that pee.
And they're never surprised by that.
No. Just pee. Why can't I just shit in the cup?
I don't know. that wasn't where I was going, but that's funny because I was thinking, what if you did a three? You're just like, here you go.
You're like, look at that. Probably a million sperm in there.
What if you did all three in a cup and just put all three in that little magic door? I didn't know what you wanted.
I'll do a fourth cup. I'll cut myself, put a little blood in it.
Oh, God.
I mean, the worst.
I know you're going to ask for this next. Here. Yeah.
Here's. All right. So this one's the blood. This one's the poop.
You can tell because it's red.
Yeah. This one's the poop. Now, it looks a little red. It got messy in there. That's not blood in my stool, so discount that. I don't want to hear anything about blood in my stool. This one's pee. And this gallon jug here. This gallon jug, that's my cum. You save that up.
But you knew that.
You save that up for a month and bring God. It in there. And you're like, boom, one load.
I won't be back for 5 years. You've got all you need.
You can freeze some of that if you want. Yeah. Do whatever you want with it.
By the way, I need a Gatorade.
I'm exhausted. Yeah. I'm running low on fuel. You got any like oranges back there? Yeah. Fuck. And a Maui Brewing Company Sunshine Girl, if you don't mind.
Yeah. For the effort. Yeah, that's weird, man.
You literally ship your
shit. People must do that every day, too.
Every day.
So just think, every probably UPS truck you see riding around has got a box of shit in it.
And that UPS driver who delivers to that facility has a truck full of shit.
Oh, Lord.
Full of shit.
New guy gets that route.
Every time. Welcome aboard, Bob. So
they're like,
your uniform.
This one's only one stop. Nobody else wants it? Nah, Bob, you're good.
Don't worry. When a new guy starts, we'll take you off the route. But for now, like, man, this must be a bad route. I guess it goes right through the ghetto or something. No. You're going out there to
just
the medical
a few miles
office.
Down the road.
Yeah, it's right there. It's real easy
one
route.
One stop. All the packages go there.
Why'd you give me this hermetically sealed suit? Like, trust me, Bob. We lost Todd a couple years ago. He stumbled and he fell into it.
Does everyone wear rubber gloves all day? Is that
just you, Bob?
Yeah,
just you. All the shit comes through you. I mean, isn't that weird?
That is weird.
And it's a UPS store. Like, how they and as a salesperson, I can respect like wanting to win an account.
Yeah.
But, like, you kind of just screwed your whole company. You're like, hey, guys, I won the Cologuard account.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, that's great. What is that?
Somebody's like, oh, Color Guard? Like, flags? Like, we're shipping all the flags
oh,
around?
Oh, no.
Yeah, the Color Guard. Yeah, my daughter does that. Yeah, like, dude, they have, like, 8 flags each. It's going to be...
No,
what? It's going to be...
Cola
that's a lot
guard.
Of flags.
No, there's there's only one R. It's Cola Guard.
Well, what the hell is that?
Oh, it's shit. In a box. But it's medical grade.
Oh, now it's okay.
Yeah. So I won
I
the
thought
account.
We arrested that one guy that was doing that.
No. That guy was off the grid. No, see, that doesn't count.
So this that is, guy, bad.
No, literally
these
insurance.
Thousands of guys.
Yeah.
Good.
Insurance pays for this.
Oh.
Oh, yeah. This is on the up and up.
Oh, insurance money. Oh, yeah. Keep that coming.
It's on the up and up. We're going to be sending shit all day.
That one guy didn't care. He paid all the money.
Yeah, I get it. That guy was weird, though. That guy was weird. You know, they've never been able to sell that house.
Yeah, I wonder why.
Yeah, I think it's all the shit.
I think they just set it on fire.
I think it's all the shit.
Pushed it over.
Actually, no, someone did just buy it. Merrick bought it.
Yeah.
And they opened a Cola Guard facility because it was already tainted.
Yeah, that's what they're going to do there.
Yeah. No, we're good.
Checks out.
We're good.
Yeah.
This happens.
Oh, my gosh. I never thought about the logistics of that. But, yeah, that's pretty wild.
Dude, that shit is crazy. So, I know someone who was doing a hiring, and they were, like, going to hire this person.
And the Kohler guard guy?
No, but this got me thinking about it. So my buddy was telling me about they had a prospect for work, and they drug tested the person because that's like what they do, right?
Are we still do people still do that?
I guess so.
I'm very confused about this whole drug thing.
I don't know. But they tested it, and it came back as animal urine.
Oh, my God.
Now, at first, I was like, okay, the person probably has something to hide. But he's like, no, but it was animal urine. Like, yeah. That's what came back. He was like,
where did he get
how the fuck do you get animal urine? And I was like, you know, that's a really good question. Like, how do you get
I can get you some animal urine.
How?
You want to know? I got a guy.
You got a guy?
No, actually, I think I could get dog urine.
How is a dog going to pee into a cup?
There are certain spots when I walk my dog around the block that I can tell every dog pisses at.
But you could get a cup under there real quick?
I bet if you just sat a cup there.
Eventually, you get
enough pee. There's this one bush at the corner house that poor dude, he's got a beautiful yard, and he's got this one little bush the size of a basketball. The rest, and there's a whole row of them, and this one.
They can't stop peeing.
Oh, my God. It is just dead. It is so dead. The dogs just light it up.
Maybe like, you just stick some Tupperware under there.
Yeah.
But, like, what kind of a drug addict? Like, I don't know. Sometimes it impresses me. How far?
So drug addicts are usually crafty about this
kind of
stuff.
Crafty as shit.
Even the bad drug ones.
But that's what's like.
Like, you hear stories about heroin addicts, like, grifting shit, you know, from their families and friends. Like, you can't be more creative than that. Like, you really thought that was going
to
pass?
You ever listen to the comedian Shane Gillis?
Yes.
He does a bit where he talks about how his sister was a heroin addict. And he was like, at first, you know, it's kind of cool because, you know, like you do heroin and then you wake up in the morning. It's like a video game because you wake up and then there's like a quest. Every day is a quest. And you don't know what that quest is going
to
be.
I got to get the heroin, but how am I going to get to the heroin?
Yeah. And he was equating it to like a video game.
Yeah.
Where you wake up every morning next to your heroin addict friends.
Yeah.
And they go, I've got a quest. And he's like, ooh, and he was like, it's like super fun at first when it's like, let's go get the copper from this place. And like, you go on a quest to get the copper.
You're like a little heroin addicted Indiana Jones trying to get like.
Yeah. So every day there's a quest and you wake up and you go do your quest and then you can go get your heroin and like you wake up the next day.
Yeah.
And he was like, it was super fun watching my sister do all these quests for like a while.
Yeah.
But then the quest turned into like. Letting a motherfucker titty fuck me at the bus station. And I was like, oh, yeah, okay, I can see how that. But at first, the way he was saying it, he was romanticizing it like it was a video game.
Yeah.
Shane Gillis is a funny.
He is pretty damn funny.
He's a funny son of a bitch, man. And he like he got canceled and like was like,
he's killing
I don't
it.
Think so. And yeah, like, he just kept it. Going.
He has a newish Netflix special out that's pretty damn funny.
Yeah, he's done good work. But I was laughing my ass off when I heard
that. Yeah, because then. The addicts are like, yeah, we could go to all these houses and steal all this stuff and go to the recycling plant and get up. Or we'll just go to the bus stop. Yeah. We could be in and out in 30 minutes.
Or I know what we do. We rob this UPS truck.
Yeah. We get all the poo.
Like, oh, no. It was literally a whole truck of shit.
Look, guys, I got a whole truck. This new guy, Bob, he didn't put up a fight at all. Another box of shit.
I can't believe it. His whole truck was full of shit.
What are the chances? Does the P in UPS stands for poop? Why is there so much poop in this truck?
Poop service. Damn it.
They're all doped up like, what is going on?
Can we get high on shit?
Are you guys high? Is it just me or is this another box of shit?
Worst quest ever.
I think I'm going to stop doing all these drugs.
And it worked.
Yeah.
It worked. Kohler Guard's just taking people off of drugs one person at a time. They just drive through all the shitty neighborhoods with the Kohler Guard.
The the bait UPS truck.
Yeah. One door's just swinging open out the back.
Hey. Just asking to be
our quest taken over. Just arrived. Yeah. Yeah, that okay, that kind of kills me.
Yeah, that's yeah, that the whole drug thing, like I've never heard anybody doing the animal thing. I've heard that, like, oh, this guy, you know, got his urine test and found out he's pregnant. You know, like
I've heard those stories. Yeah. And I've always heard that. Like, be careful. Like, don't, if you're going to get someone's urine, don't get a woman. God forbid you find out she's pregnant. Or
I always wonder too, like, is that one of those old wives' tales, or is it like urban legend? Because like, would they not be able to tell it's a woman only because you're pregnant? Like, do they run a pregnancy test through the urine? That doesn't sound right. Like, why would they do that? Especially if it's a dude.
But maybe there's something elevated naturally in the urine where you're like, oh, yeah, that's weird. It's
awful. Yeah, I don't know how it works. But yeah, I mean, being that marijuana's legal now.
Yeah, but it's still federally illegal. So it's like.
But I always wonder too, like, when they drug test, what are they drug testing for?
A lot of places don't even test it. They just want to see if you'll show up.
Yeah.
Because that's like the first thing is get the people to show up. The hardcore drug addicts go, it's not going to work.
Yeah.
I'm not even going to do this. I didn't realize they were going to test me.
Oh, Tuesday? That's not going to work for me.
Yeah. When they start hemming and hawing, you go, all right, good enough. We'll move on.
Yeah.
So I've known that. I worked for a company where I found out later, they don't even test it. It was literally like, they just make you show up, and it's like $20 just to accept the piss cup.
They just pour it out.
And then pour it out. But it was like $100 to accept the piss cup and test it.
Yeah.
And the company was so big that they were like, well, with all the people we're churning through, we just want to get rid of the hardcore drug addicts.
Yeah.
Who were like, we can't do it. So that's what they did.
Makes sense.
Yeah. It's a cost-cutting measure.
Well, it's like, can you imagine, like, entry-level jobs, whatever they may be, minimum wage jobs, like, you're going to drug test these people? Like, do they drug test them? And, like, do you not expect them to be smoking pot on their days off? Like, how could you possibly expect that?
I mean, I would just test for certain drugs.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like,
heroin?
Just heroin, meth, coke.
Meth.
Kind of keep it, like, right there. Be like, because the reality is you could test to see if someone had been drinking.
The only thing I know too is the only thing I've always heard is marijuana stays in your system for a long time and cocaine does not. But what does what's meth and heroin do?
Same thing, 48 hours.
So they're pretty in and out.
So if you can't stay clean for 48 hours, then you have a problem.
Yeah.
Like pot, you could be at a concert in August and fail a drug test in September.
Yeah.
And be like, oops, fucked that up. That's the unfortunate thing about
it. Did they ever figure out a pot, like, can you secondhand that?
I've never heard of anybody failing a drug test from secondhand smoke. Then again, I'm not.
But I've also never known anyone to die of secondhand smoke, but they tell you 40 million people die every year of secondhand smoke.
Yeah.
But
imagine if you.
How do they prove that?
What if you collected dog piss from someone who lived in a house of a pothead?
Yeah.
And then you fail for pot.
Yeah.
You're like, that doesn't even make sense. I'm a meth addict. I mean, shit.
Hey, we're going to need you to come back in and we're going to run some tests on you. Not drug related. We just want to know what the fuck you are.
It just appears you have heartworm?
Yeah.
We're just trying to figure this out.
Congrats, you got the job. Here's your new collar.
Yeah. So we're actually putting you in a different section. Now that we know that you're a dog.
You get 2 walks a day.
This motherfucker should have been like, I identify as a dog.
Dude.
Now we got now it's like you put it back on him.
Yeah.
Throwing it right back on him.
No, now they sue because you didn't get the job.
And it turns out, not only do I identify as a dog, but I identify so hard.
That's right.
That I pee dog pee.
That's right.
Like, so now you're telling me, not only can I not identify a dog, but you now have physical proof that I am a dog.
When I applied for that job, it didn't say dogs need not apply.
It didn't. And if it did,
then we have a whole nother problem.
So which way are we going to go here?
Yeah. Your move, asshole.
Yeah. That's check.
Yeah.
Make your move. Yeah. Let's see how this goes.
It's 2024, brother.
That's right.
You want to play this game? Yeah.
I told you.
That's
right. Told you identified as a dog.
I gave
now you have proof.
I gave you that perfectly clean dog urine. I don't know. It is my dog. He might have been stoned. I don't know. My dog smokes. It's not me.
It's a fucking dog.
Yeah. It's Spot. That son of a bitch always taking bong hits. It's
constantly.
I don't know what he's doing when I'm not at home on my quest. Oh, wait, what?
Copper doesn't just show up here, motherfucker. I'm busy. What the hell? How do these go off the rails so fast? I keep trying to get fast?
The heroin, UPS to deliver heroin. It's just box of shit.
More shit. Just steady. Steady. I just keep marking them clean.
Yeah.
Check. All of a sudden, all the people are like, cool, I don't have anything wrong.
Yeah, I'm good.
Yeah, I hope this thing... Oh, I can't wait to shit in the box. And then
no,
I
you haven't
hope,
done it yet.
No, I'm super excited. Can't wait.
That,
not gonna
that'll
do
be
it.
Fun.
Not going to do it after a long weekend.
There's got to be rules, too, right? Like,
well, how runny is it allowed
that's
to
what
be?
I'm saying. Like, what if you're not having a good day?
Well, I mean, I can't do it on a Monday. I can't.
Because you know after Sundays, you're just, your gut's not right.
Especially after coming up after the Super Bowl this weekend. I guarantee I'm going to be just, it'll ruin the box. It'll seep right through.
This box is leaking. Oh, no.
Yeah, man. Like, I'm going to have to eat just a lot of cheese.
Yeah.
Couple of days, bind it up, give them a nice log.
Oh,
I can't believe this is how it works, though. Like, when I asked for it, I hadn't really thought it through. And then it got explained to me, and I've had a couple people explain it to me now, and I'm like, they all say the same thing.
No, but you should just go. You should just schedule a colonoscopy.
It sounds easier to shit in a box.
I just I would do more research to see if that, like, can they determine.
Basically,
without the scope going in you and seeing what's inside of you, can they determine?
Yes, the only thing they can't find is polyps.
Yeah, well, that's important, though.
Yeah, because the polyps are what leads to it. No, that's it. Because when the scope goes in, it sees the polyps, and they can...
You get a colonoscopy, and then you're good for 5 years. So it's not like it's an annual thing.
So maybe the colonoscopy, the beauty of the colonoscopy is the clean out of the polyps.
Yeah. Yeah, and then if they do find a polyp, they take care of it, and then...
They take care of it right then.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. They just go, fuck this. Yep. All right. Well, so right now, I got the Cologuard guard. I got the box shit.
Yeah.
They're going to tell me if there's anything in there that means I have to go get a colonoscopy.
Yeah.
That's basically all they're doing. But you're right. I should probably run a polyp cleaning every once in a while.
And you could probably just schedule that on your own. Or if you go the next time you're a doctor, just ask, and they'll reference you.
Well, we're going to shit in the box.
Well, yeah. I mean, you don't want to pass that up.
The 90s was dick in a box.
Yeah.
Or 2000, early 2000, dick in a box. Now it's shit in a box.
Yeah.
I'm going to do the shit in the box. Then maybe I'll give it a few years if everything comes back. And maybe we'll do a milestone birthday.
Yeah.
Go knock out a little polyp cleanse.
There you go.
I'm sure there's nothing.
Get it on get it on the birthdays that, you know, end in 0 and 5.
That's what I'm saying. And then just shit in a box the other years.
Yeah. Or not. Or maybe you don't have to.
I think once you start shitting in a box.
Well, you're going to enjoy shitting in a box.
I'm going to love shitting in a box. I am. I mean, let's be honest. You know? First step, cut a hole in the box.
Yeah.
Second step, put your shit in that box.
Third step, you open the box.
That's right. Now your quest is over.
That's right. Oh, Lord. That was, none of these were written down.
I did have UPS shit.
Oh, okay. That was written down.
But yeah, the rest of these just stayed right where they were. I don't know how that went off the rails.
It just does.
So quickly.
It just does.
Well, guys, thanks for tuning in.
Yeah, thanks for sitting with us for another episode.
Appreciate you obliging us while we...
We didn't take any weeks off during the holidays, like every other podcast I listen to.
Isn't that the truth? Like, multiple weeks.
And they just put out fucking best ofs over and over and over. And I'm like, I listened to all your shit. I don't want to re-listen to all of these for 2 weeks.
I don't mind.
I'd rather just not put out anything.
Some of them did that.
Yeah.
Which actually frustrated me more. I think I'm actually a fan of the best of, more so than the just don't show up.
Yeah.
It kind of annoyed me.
I like when they can pulling in a two in the can. If you do weekly podcasts, that's not hard.
It shouldn't be.
Well, I say that. We put zero work into this, so it's not hard for us. But if you, a lot of them that, you know, do a lot of pre and post. And
oh, no, I put a lot of work into this.
We didn't. You didn't even have to get the beer this week.
Literally did nothing. It was beautiful. It was great.
We didn't even talk about this.
What?
Podcasting this week.
No, it like came up. It like I was literally sitting on my couch. It was like 8 o'clock, and I was like, "Is Troy going to show up?" And I was like, "Yeah, he'll show up." My wife was like, "You should probably call him." I was like, "Nah, he'll show up."
I was going to be here right at 8, and I just got into Jeopardy, and I was like, "If I'm there at 8:10, it'll be fine."
Well, and that's what got me. It was like 8:07.
Yeah,
and I was like, "Oh man," I was like, "Do I have to say there's a certain pride I take in like having a conversation a week before." And then never discussing it again and just being at that spot.
Yeah.
And having the person show up and go, that's how we used to do it.
Yep.
Because that's how the world was. And then I was.
But now we're busy.
Yeah. So my wife was like, is he coming? And at like 7:30, she was like, have you guys talked? And I go, nah, he'll be here. And then it was like 8 o'clock. She goes, well, is he coming? And I was like, yeah, he'll be here. She goes, he's always on time. And I go, well, it was 8:07. That's when she goes. He may not know. And I was like, ah, crap, I'll reach out. Of course, I reach out and you're like, yeah, motherfucker, I'm in the car. I'm like, damn it. I just wanted it to just be natural. Is that too much to ask?
It's all good. It's all good.
What can you do? What can you do? But thank you guys so much for tuning in. Hope you all had a fantastic New Year's. Yeah, that's right. Everyone else, they're doing great. Doing great. They're living their best life.
Still waiting on that Squeeze of Lemons episode.
It'll come out. It'll come out. Well, thank you guys so much for tuning in and week out. We do appreciate the support. If you are looking to support us, I think the easiest way to support us is send topics, send funny things. Do so at
Inside the Beer.
The beer's nice. The beer's nice. But you can always find us at InsideThePalateHouse@gmail.com. Very easy way to send a topic to us. If that's the bridge too far and you're just one of those people who just likes to send money, that's fine too.
At Inside the Pallet House of Venmo.
It's super easy.
Really easy.
Just send money there. Or if you want to find us on socials, you can always do so on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. Those handles are at?
At Inside the Pallet House Podcast?
ITPH Podcast.
ITPH Podcast. There it is. Yeah, something like that. Just Google it.
Just go on Facebook.
Yeah.
You have a Facebook account because that's the only way you can buy certain things. You know you do.
Just you're old.
Do it there. If you need sunglasses, head over to NectarSunglasses.com. Drop Abacus in the coupon code, and you will get 20% off what is already a good deal.
Yes.
And if you live in Georgia or Virginia and you need a mortgage, do yourself a favor and go to ScreenDoorMortgage.com. Ask them to give you a quote. I think you will be pleasantly surprised at how the process works over there. Jimmy will take care of it.
If nothing else, you will enjoy your time speaking with them and their wonderful customer service.
Yeah, and a dope-ass Yeti cup when it's all said and done as a thank you gift. Just saying. It is pretty sweet. There's two of them in front of us
right
now.
Two of them right here.
Thank you guys so much for tuning in. We'll be talking to you next week. Cheers.
Cheers.
I don't know how we do it.
That was a pretty good podcast, don't you think?